Hello students, I am Sandhya Kulkarni. We have met each other in the last English lessons. Hope you all have learned the poetry by heart. Today I am going to teach you EVS 2. This year in this EVS 2 lesson you are going to learn all about Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Who is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj? That and his full life story we are going to learn this year. See, India is a land of rulers. There were many rulers. Maharashtra is a part of India. It's one of the important state of India. Even in Maharashtra, we have seen many eminent rulers. This time, we are going to learn about Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj.
Do you remember this person, children? Can you recognize him? Yes, he is Shivaji Maharaj. Who is Shivaji Maharaj? Shivaji Maharaj was the greatest king of Maharashtra. He was a great man. Do you know, in the month of February, on 19th, every year we celebrate his birthday? Why? Why do we have to celebrate his birthday? He was such a great king who brought happiness to the people. People were very happy under his rule. So, even today, we remember him, we respect him, and we love him. Children garland his pictures on his birthday and sing pavadas. What are pavadas? Pavadas are the songs which are based on great deeds of Shivaji Maharaj. Usually these pavadas are in the form of story but recited in the form of a song. These pavadas are passed on from one person to another. Children also praise Shivaji Maharaj saying, Shivaji Maharaj ki jai. The time in which Shivaji Maharaj lived is called as medieval period. What do you mean by medieval? Medieval means middle. Very old history, we call it as ancient period. And the new one, we call it as modern history. But Shivaji lived during the medieval period. In those days, many kings were ruling India. The king of Maharashtra was not there. Actually, it was in the control of sultans. Who are these sultans? Sultans were the Muslim rulers. Now, many of the kings who were there, they were very selfish. They always thought about themselves. They never bothered how the people are living, what can make them happy, whether they are happy or not. They were not bothered about it. But there were also kings who thought about welfare of the people. They treated all the people like their own children. They were Krishnadevaraya. Krishnadevaraya was the ruler of Vijayanagar Empire. He was the emperor who was very famous in the south. He was very famous for his great rule. Even Akbar. Akbar was the emperor of Mughals. He looked after people like his own children. He treated Hindus and Muslims equally. People were very happy during their period. Even Shivaji Maharaj was as good and courageous like Akbar and Krishnadevaraya. So, we respect him a lot. Today, we are going to learn the lesson Maharashtra before Shivaji. Before Shivaji Maharaj started ruling Maharashtra, people were in very bad condition. They were very sad. They were very unhappy. Why? Now, let's see this. This is Maharashtra. Before Shivaji Maharaj, Maharashtra was under the rule of Adil Shah of Bijapur and Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar. These two sultans were not at all good to the people. They both were Muslims, but they were great enemies of each other. You all have heard about great friendship, but these two sultans were the sworn enemies of each other. This is Adil Shah of Bijapur and this is Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar. These two rulers were always fighting with each other. They were also very narrow-minded. They did not allow the people to celebrate the festivals like Diwali and Holi. So, people were very unhappy with these sultans. Not only this, there were lot of robbery, theft in the kingdom. Soldiers and other people used to enter the houses of the people and take away whatever they could. So, people were not safe even in their homes. So you can imagine how sad they were. These sultans had appointed officers. These officers used to collect revenue from the people. What is revenue? Revenue means tax. Now if we are living in a house, we have to pay the tax. And whatever we earn, for that also we have to pay tax. In those days, farmers used to pay grains in the form of tax. So, these officers used to go and collect tax from the people. Sometimes they used to collect less tax, sometimes they used to collect more. When they collected more tax, Adil Shah and Nizam Shah, they used to become very happy upon these officers. So when they became happy, they used to give jagir to these officers. What is a jagir? Jagir is a piece of land which is given to the person for whatever the work he did. Now, your parents and myself, we get salary for whatever the work we do. But it was not so in those days. They used to give jagir, means vatan, means a piece of land for whatever the work the officers did. You can observe here. Now I have marked it a piece of land and arrow is pointing towards that. See, whenever an officer did some work and if Adil Shah became very happy about that officer, he used to give that piece of land as a gift. So, these officers, every time they tried to make these sultans happy. So, they tried to collect more and more tax. These officers were Deshmukhs and Deshpandes. They were also selfish. Once they got the jagir, they used to think themselves as the Raja of the jagir. They always thought accumulating more and more jagir. They too did not thought about welfare of the people. So because of all these things, people were very unhappy and very sad during the period of these sultans. If they tried to go and complain to any officers, the people were punished. So nobody had the courage to go and complain about anybody. All these things Shivaji Maharaj observed from childhood. So he had decided when he grows up, he is going to make the people happy. He will make the people happy by establishing Swaraj. Shivaji wanted to make all the people happy. So he went and spoke to Deshmukhs and Deshpandes, who are Jagirdars because they were having Jagir, and also called as Vatandars because the meaning is same. He went and talked to these Vatandars, made them to understand about Swaraj. What is Swaraj? Swaraj means self-government. I told you, in a kingdom, king was the head and no one else had the authority to go and change any rules or regulation. But in Swaraj, it was not so. If anybody had any problem, they could go and talk to the king directly, and Shivaji Maharaj used to solve their problem immediately. So Shivaji Maharaj fought with these Deshmukhs and Deshpandes and defeated them. And at last, he was able to establish Hindavi Swaraj. Hindavi, whoever who lived in Swaraj was called as Hindavi. So their Raj was Swaraj. Hindavi Swaraj was based on justice, fair play and equal treatment to all the people of all the castes and religions. Hindus and Muslims were treated equally. Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Mahars were also treated equally. So when we observe this, Shivaji was a great king. He honored all the saints. There were many Muslim saints as well as Hindu saints. He honored both of them. From these things, we learn that all are equal. We should respect everyone. And by this equality, we can live happily. So far, children, we learnt about the life of Maharashtra people before Shivaji came. So let us try to recall what all we have learnt today. We praise Shivaji Maharaj because he was a great ruler like Krishnadevaraya and Akbar. Shivaji Maharaj lived in the medieval period. He established Swaraj. Swaraj means self-government. Vatandas were selfish too. Shivaji fought with Deshmukhs and Deshpandes, who were Vatandas, and defeated them. Hindavi Swaraj was based on justice, fair play and equal treatment to people of all the castes and religion.
Hope you all enjoyed the lesson, children. Read the textbook. I think you all have already downloaded the ebook from Diksha app. If not, do it today itself. Read the lesson and see the video. And then if you have any doubts, please let me know. The assignments and the notes will be sent to you via WhatsApp. Thank you. See you in my next class.